going to go, instead of doing outdoor parking, we're going to do covered parking. Saves a little time. But I'm only here for like, in the parking garage for like a day. So the cost difference isn't like a week of staying in the, in the covered parking. I always like going to the west side. That would be the east side if I would have taken a right there. But I always go to the west. Yeah, I never really do this, but we'll figure it out together. I just already see that there's a parking garage. It goes to the right, which is what I would expect. Instead of going straight, which is the cheap route. So I guess my fellow BMW wanted to cut me off. That's okay, Z4. Welcome to my YouTube channel. It's a beautiful day today, though. It's, as you can tell, it's perfect blue skies, no clouds. Man, this girl's taking forever. All you gotta do is press a button here. We'll show you how simple this is.
Reading license plate.
Oh, okay.
Welcome. Your ticket is being issued.
Look, see, you just press it. Since it's being issued, it should pop out. Here,
please
there,
take
there.
Your ticket. Thank you.
That's all the amount of time it should have taken. She took, like, I don't know. You can watch it back. Watch it back. It's probably like 2 minutes. But yeah, there's the hotel over there, the airport. Level one's lower, so we'll try to get closer to where I want to get. I can see a bunch of United planes taking off here. Wow, it's like 1, 2, 3, 4 in queue, and one just took off. All right, so here it's telling us level one is open. This is $28 a day, and I think we want to go up. Looks like level three. Four maybe. It says turn right here, but I don't know if I had to do that. I think I could have kept on going there. I'm not seeing too many places open, but let's drive around a bit. I'm not in a huge hurry. My flight, it doesn't take off for like an hour and 20 minutes. This one's gonna be more crowded because it's the level you want to be on. This is where you, this is the level you'd get off on if when you get out of your out of the tram system. So my guess is this will be a little more crowded, but I just saw a spot, so I'm gonna take it. Because we're not far away. There's nobody behind me, but there's a spot right there. So yeah. There you go. That's how easy that is. All right, now that I've parked there, I am going to Monroe, Louisiana. Pretty sure that's what it is. I've never heard of this city before in my life, but I'm flying to Dallas first, so that's what this video will be. It'll be Denver to Dallas. And like I showed you earlier, clear skies. It looks like a beautiful day. And yeah, we'll see what we find out. Already seeing some wildlife here in the parking garage. We got, I don't know if you see that. There's a bird there. There's a bird there. He stopped when I stopped. Let's see how close we can get to him, eh? This thing's probably pretty used to people. All right. That was fun. All right. So there are signs that say like two terminals so you don't get lost or confused on this. It's a pretty straightforward process. I have some trash to throw away, so this is perfect. I think it's trash only. You know what's incredible about this Toyota FJ Cruiser? It's one of the few cars that is worth more now than when they were selling it. Fun fact. It's got a loyal fan base, apparently. Another sign right there said two terminal. Just keep on going like this, and basically there's these, this area you're gonna walk over. This is where passenger drop-off is. Or no, this is passenger pickup. This is technically passenger pickup. So when you pick up your luggage, you come out here and wait for your people to pick you up. There's literally no wait, which is incredible. Normally, this is always really busy, so what people do is they go to the floor above, and that's the hack to get in and picking up people a lot quicker than the way you're supposed to. Look at that. It's a free phone. You don't have to pay a quarter. That's incredible. You can smoke on air, apparently. Oh, I need to get a mask. They still require a mask at the airports. So here we go. Don't have to check in any bags because
attention,
I'm carrying everything.
The sound security checkpoint is the primary checkpoint for passengers. TSA pre-check passports must be.
I'm just going straight to the security area. That's a baggage claim. An idea where that came from. And of course you have to go to the left here, even though there is security to the right. That place that doesn't have TSA pre, as the sign says, you gotta go this way for TSA pre. It's very open here. That guy's got a blanket. It's gonna be comfy on his flight. Got a little interview or something going on here. This is another side stand. TSA Airlines this way. This is kind of cool. I've never shown this in a video. This thing we're gonna walk straight up to, this big thing of America. Looks like these people want to check it out too. I'll wait for them to get done. All right, that was quick, but okay, so here we are. All right, then we're flying down to good old Dallas. Then from there, going over to Louisiana. Now Monroe is like here, I think. So, gonna be a fun one today. This is a cool little map though. Then you got this right by it. Don't know who Gary Sweeney is. Maybe I should know who this is. But apparently that's his parents. and that is in Bryce Canyon, Utah. So, all right, time to go to security. No line here. No line at security, great stuff. Made it through security, of course, to be expected. I don't think you can fly through Denver and not see a dog. I really don't. So there's some more construction here. That's new. And go left over. Everybody seems to go this way. So today, this flight's out of Gate C. It's arriving. It has arrived.
Board here.
Ooh, we'll try this. It goes this way. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it does. Let's go this way. I like to sit down.
Thank you.
The doors are closing. Please keep clear and hold on for departure to all species.
Or something. I think I'm gate like 50 or something. But we're gonna double check. So this is American Airlines flight. We're going to Dallas. It's up here. It's on time. And you can see like right there. 850 like 43. Oh, 2579. I don't know what the other number was. On time. 850. 8:50. All right, so just give you a little look-see around here because I never really go to the sea terminal. That's the train that you take. We just got off of. We were on this side. That's where you go to get back to pick up your bags and that way. Weird being in a terminal you never go to. It's like a whole new world. It's a big airplane there. Kind of cool. All right, so 50, C50. Hold on. This is the same problem I made before in the past. I need to be at A50, not C50. Why did I think it would need to be at C? Okay, we're gonna go back to those trains that I just showed you. I went the wrong way. I'm an idiot. There, I said it, it's on video. I'm an idiot. I'm going the wrong freaking way. All right, so. That tram wasn't going at all. Perfectly still. This one's moving. Alright. I can't believe I did this. This one was totally my fault. Okay, so we got 2 minutes. I'm gonna walk down to the other side so we get the front view. I can't believe I came all the way to the sea gates for nothing. All right, you know, this is only the second time I've done this, but I've hit record on this thing like 2 or 3 times now. I thought I did, and I didn't. So yeah, have fun with that. Here we go. See you in a bit. Alright. Another dog. This is where I should have got off 10 minutes ago. Alright. So, I don't make that many mistakes like this, but obviously I have plenty of time today, so it's not a big deal. I already know it's 8:50. Here's how I noticed my mistake. I was like reading it. As soon as I looked at the sign that said gate C, whatever, let's say 40 to 99, I was like, I'm looking for A. There's a Ben and Jerry's over here. Where is it there? You can kind of see it through there. All right, I'm gonna get some water here. Then we'll head over to 8:50. Go for a walk. If I was in a hurry, I would have just walked up behind them and said, excuse me. Just have to move. But my flight boards at 12:11 is when they start, so I got like still 15 minutes. It's funny, this says it goes to A99. It looks like we're at the end, so I don't know how you get to 99. Let's go try to figure it out. American does not have good gates here. These are far out. Oh, look at this. You go down. Let's go down there. Never been down here. So that's my gate right here, 50. Everybody's waiting. Let's get on here. See what the... I'm not sure where this goes. It's just... Oh, United has some stuff? Some bathrooms down here? Literally nobody. I saw somebody walk down here when I first came down here. Look down this really quick. There's food and shops down here, it says. The sign says food and shops to the right. Huh. You can see a plane right here. This is you board from above the, not this level. See that plane? It's a big one. Some people's luggage. All right. I did not know United had gates over here in A. It's crazy though. Keeps on going and going. Look at this one really quick. 60 through 68. Goes way down there. These are all little bitty planes. They have to be small commuter planes. What's nice about this area though is it's really quiet. Not a lot of people making noise down here. It's like being in a lounge. This is my gate. We'll go over and look at the plane. That's it. How much to see here? Better shot. Afternoon, whatever it is. All right, so 30F.
You were overflowing so hard.
I spent energy overflowing now.
Three quarters of yours was like.
Gentlemen, for those of you who just joined us, welcome aboard.
I think I said it's
full flight. Place your carry-on items in an overhead compartment. Put your roller boards in wheels first, and then please turn them to their side so that we can accommodate everybody's luggage. It's going to be very full in light today. So we'd be grateful if
now it's very full.
Card. You might need to look at the exit in an emergency.
Got to go to 30.
Insert the metal end into the buckle and pull the strap so it's tight across your hips. To open your seatbelt, lift the top of the buckle. And remember, seatbelts should be fastened whenever you're seated in case of unexpected turbulence. U.S. law requires compliance with lighted and posted signs and crew member instructions. All flights are non-smoking, including e-cigarettes. It's against the law to tamper with, disable, or destroy the lavatory smoke detectors. Doing so may result in a fine. The safety card in your seat pocket explains the safety features of this airplane, including the location and operation of exits and flotation devices. But of course, don't hesitate to ask our crew members questions. This airplane has 8 exit doors, 4 on each side of the aircraft. Take a moment to locate the nearest one. Keep in mind, it may be behind you. All door exits have evacuation slides to use in the unlikely event of an emergency. When directed to exit, jump onto the slide and move away from the airplane. In a water evacuation, slides at the front and back of the airplane may be used as life rafts. An additional raft is located in a marked overhead bin. All exits are clearly marked with signs and opening instructions. If needed, exit path lighting in the aisle will illuminate near the floor to guide you to an exit in
during the flight. You may briefly lift or lower your face mask while eating or drinking. Please keep your mask on if you want to sleep so we don't have to wake you. In addition, federal regulations prohibit smoking, including the use of vaping devices, at any time on board the aircraft. Electronic smoking devices may not be plugged into a power source, including USB ports and AC outlets. We're coming through the aisle now for our final safety and face mask checks. Now more than ever, we appreciate you choosing American. Sit back, relax, and enjoy your flight. Thank you for your attention.
Take off.
past 3. As a reminder, please stay seated with your seatbelt fastened until the seatbelt sign is off and keep the aisle clear of all items. Don't forget to check your seat back pocket and surrounding area to ensure you have all your belongings like cell phones, tablets or chargers. And just please be aware that once you exit the aircraft, you won't be able to get back on it again. So please make sure you have all your personal belongings with you. And to help keep our cabin clean, we ask that you please take any remaining items with you and place them in a trash bin once you exit the aircraft. And when you open the overhead compartment, please be careful as items may have shifted in flight. And you may now use your cell phone. If you're connecting onto a flight in Dallas, you can use the Skylink trains that run every 2 minutes here in Dallas, and they go to all the terminals. We're going to be arriving at Terminal B, Gate B12, that's B for Bravo 12, and your baggage claim is B5. We know you have a choice of airline. We thank you for choosing American Airlines. On behalf of our One World partners and your Dallas-Fort Worth crew, we thank you for flying with us today. We hope you have a very safe onward journey, and we look forward to seeing you again on another American Airlines flight. Have a good day, and thank you once again.
So I had this idea to use FlightAware to show you guys exactly the path that this plane took. As you'll see here, it shows you the altitude and the speed. You can zoom in on it and do a little more stuff. This flight is going 10 times the actual speed of the flight itself, so obviously we don't have to sit here for the entire flight to watch this. But you know, you see like, oh, we went through Oklahoma and where exactly we went in Texas. As you'll see, we'll come down here in Dallas to make the approach we did. We'll actually go past the airport and loop back around it. I just think it's kind of neat to see the actual information for the flight there. There we go, we're landed.
Thank you.
First class.
Bye.
Thank you. Connection. So that's the Skylink, is their little tram system, their little train. You go over here, take it. I might take it just to show you. Let's go look at our gate, just make sure. See if Monroe is even on here. It's gotta be. Yeah, I see it. So it's one of those flights. I can't believe there's more than one flight to that city. Which one are we? We're for. Just moved 437 on time, B25. You see it there at the bottom. But that's the end of this video. If you like it, be sure to hit subscribe and like. Mainly like. If you like it, it gets sent to more people. And you'll see all the other videos I do in the future like this. Next is going to be... what is it? The one going to Monroe. Yeah. The place I'm already about to go to. So... be sure to hit that. All right, that's it. Bye. I'm speaking stupid.